If you haven't got a chance, make sure to grab the Zephyr Sword before the dawning is over. It comes with an intrinsic perk, Cold Steel, that allows you to slow and freeze enemies in Destiny 2, which I know sounds crazy. You can freeze a target in as little as 3 light hits. This paired with other stasis abilities allows you to create an overpowered build to take out majors and champions of ease. Also, this build is just super fun because with a sword and some of the other items I'm going to add to this, you'll be zooming around the battlefield for maximum fun. It's really a fun build. I had a ton of fun just playing it in some of the new activities, even in some higher tier content, but let's go over some of the details. So for this build, I utilize the Revenant Hunter subclass. In addition to this, I utilize the Grim Harvest aspect that when you freeze or slow targets, you regenerate shards, which will come in handy later, as well as melee energy. I also added that several fragments. Whisper of Refraction, which defeated, slowed, or frozen targets grant you class ability energy. Whisper of Hunger gains you melee energy when picking up shards, which you've created elsewhere. Whisper of Chains allows you to reduce damage when you're near frozen targets, again for survivability. And Whisper of Rhyme allows you to generate an overshield based on how many shards you grab after generating them. For weapons, I utilize a double special loadout of Wither Horde and Salvager Salvo in addition to Zephyr. Yes, it's a double special build. I know I'm going to have ammo issues, but having 2 energy grenade launchers allows you to maximize ammo on drops from your grenade launcher scavengers and such, and they're both great for ad clear, so you only have to use them so much. In addition, Salvager Salvo allows you to chain kills with chain reaction, as well as grenade energy with demolitionists, which will allow you to have more grenades, which allow you to freeze more stuff, and freezing stuff is a lot of fun. With you freezing enemies with your stasis abilities and your sword, and ability to gain mass ad clear of grenade launchers, you will have no problem clearing the battlefield, which will allow you then to get to the majors. And again with Zephyr, I can easily freeze most major and champions to keep them in space, and then quickly do a heavy attack to finish them off. I was actually surprised at how, because again, I'm using Fallen Guillotine and things like that typically, which again, has been somewhat nerfed, but I was surprised with Zephyr how quickly I could actually take champions out without much thought. I then add to this Mask of Akris. This can be attained from solo runs of Legendary Master Lawsuckers. It has a blink ability that replaces your dodge and allows you to get very quickly into and out of travel by warping between areas. With practice, this can again allow you to get quickly out of trouble with this build, but also allows you to warp close to enemies, especially champions. You utilize your sword attack to quickly freeze and eliminate major champions really, really quickly. Again, you sense a theme here. Also, Backwards has the ability that after I shift, I do more damage against frozen targets and with arc weapons. With my grenade launcher, with chain reaction and frozen targets, I can litter the battlefield with carnage. This also helps them against majors and champions I'm trying to take down. For mods, I utilize mods that allow me to regenerate my grenade launcher ammo so I can stay in the fight. I also use two hands on mods so that when I gain super energy back on melee kills. Since I am also running Gambler's Dodge, I can easily get my melee back. And I get melee energy back from earlier portions of the build. That can help me gain my super back even quicker. Because with melee kills, hands-on, I'm getting my super energy back. If I'm dealing with an overload champion, I will also use Disrupting Blade to quickly deal with that overload of my sword. Since my sword can quickly slow and freeze enemies, this will allow me to overwhelm them before they can warp away. And again, with Backers, if they do warp away, I can get back to them really, really quickly. And then again, as I'm freezing targets around everything, I'm also gaining resistance that will allow me to stay in the fight longer against his champions. I also run Resonant Siphon to allow me to gain stasis ability energy when on a fire team when they stand champions, and that will happen quite a bit in end game higher tier content. I utilize elemental shards, which allow the shards I'm generating at will to act as elemental wells. Now remember, when I am freezing and slowing targets, I'm basically getting shards, and especially as I'm doing higher end targets, because I'm going to continuously freeze them or continuously slow them, I'm actually going to get more shards over time. I also then use elemental charge to allow those shards, which act as wells, to give me 2 charges of light. Then I throw in Well of Potency, which allows me to gain additional super energy when I pick up elemental wells, which in this case are my elemental shards, which allows me to get my super back. So again, as you can see, these elemental shards, which act as elemental wells, feed all sorts of ability things all across my build. Finally, I use Protective Light that will get me a get out of jail free card by helping me gain damage resistance when my shield is dropped during the game. Because I got Discharge of Light earlier, I actually have 2 of those and I easily get them back when I pick up elemental shards within the game. Then I round up my build with whatever champion mods, ability boosts, and resistances I need to match the content. So again, tailor that the way you want to based on what you're playing. So you can see how this build starts together. Utilize your sword to slow and freeze targets, and then again, get shards from them. Those shards give you an overshield, give you melee energy, regenerate your super, and give you protective light protection in case you get in trouble. You also gain damage resistance while near those frozen targets you create, and your melee energy gains the ability to refreeze targets back quickly, which again, then you get the melee energy back from other parts of this build. You can get out of trouble quickly with Backrest and clear adds quickly with Wither Horde and Salvager Salvo. Zephyr adds to the fun by freezing enemies and champions to allow you to quickly take them out in any endgame PvE content. And again, you have a sword and you can just swoosh it around and just get around the battlefield really quickly. Again, this build is just a ton of fun. So again, guys, that's the build. Again, this build's just been a ton of fun. It's definitely anything that has a lot of adds. Like a lot of the content we have right now, the dungeons or the dares or even some of the others, the strikes that are out there. There's just a ton of fun, ton of ability to get your abilities back, to go through a whole loop of getting your melee energy back, of freezing targets, getting super energy, freezing things through your supers, using your sword to freeze things, which protects you. And then the add clear of the grenade launchers. Again, just an incredible build. Lots of fun. Might not be the safest build all the time, but definitely something you're going to enjoy. And hey, it's Christmas. Christmas is about having fun. So enjoy this build. I hope you like it. If you did, feel free to like the video, subscribe my channel, jump in my Discord, and I'll see you Guardians in the Tower.